Hi everyone, I'm Krillius, Team Ray Scene Productions producer and MC. And today I have joining me Mike Austin. How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
I am doing pretty good. I'm doing pretty good. How are you doing with this whole pandemic and everything?
It is, you know, trying to stay safe, but also trying to keep our community safe as possible, but all is well. And, you know, just grateful to have the opportunity to you know, help our community during this pandemic.
Definitely. Has the pandemic changed any of your campaign process or the election in general or anything?
It absolutely has. It's been a huge adjustment to you know, not knock doors and to follow the mayor's order to stop canvassing. And so, you know, we've made big strides with other forms of outreach, social media, phone calls, you know, to continue to fill in some gaps as well with providing food and safety materials so that our residents stay safe as possible during this unprecedented pandemic.
Definitely. Now, you are in a very hotly contested race. How is that for you? You know, how is that for you? It's because it's heating up, you know, and I'm reading the news, I'm seeing stuff. It's a very hot race. How is that for you?
It's been amazing. Our support has been a lot more than I anticipated, and we've exceeded all of our targets and expectations to date. And so we're continuing to reach out to our neighbors and our voters and our supporters and our non-supporters. you know, when we're elected, we will be their council member as well. And so that has been it's been a big adjustment, but still the race is about a battle of ideas and about a battle of residents wanting better leadership, better representation, and better amenities and safer communities. And so that has been our platform. We will continue to talk to our residents.
Yes, definitely. And, you know, we've done an interview with you before. Racing did one, which is up on our YouTube channel. So viewers, you can go check that out. So, but what has changed, you know, since that interview? Anything significant that has changed with you, with the campaign, with anything?
Our support. I think the support it is gone through the roof, and so I'm grateful to you all for the platform. I'm grateful to the residents of Ward 8 who believe and know that we have the strongest campaign in this race, and that we have we're ready for better leadership. And so it has just been a whirlwind since that last interview, just with a lot of support, phone calls, emails, social media, you name it. And so I'm just forever grateful to all of them for allowing us to provide a platform for better representation on the council, because as our slogan is, it's now or never. And it is now or never for better leadership in Ward 8, for responsible leadership, for equitably funded schools, for responsible development, for a much stronger workforce, and really just better access to healthcare. And so those have been our priority points, and they will continue to be our points, because if we can address those, we can improve the overall life for our Ward 8 residents.
So, you know, let the viewers know, what are you bringing that will significantly, you know, make you different from the current leadership? You know, give us that. You know, what are you embodying? What are you giving that's different from the current leadership?
You know, I would say three things. And so those are experience, education, and I would say bold ideas. And so, you know, my experience extends from working at the city council to managing $100 million budgets to negotiating big contracts and to be able to deliver on what I say I'm going to do. We just don't have that right now. A lot of promises, but they're hollow. And so we want somebody who has the education and background, who understands these issues. And so as, you know, as an attorney in this race, you know, I've been able to, like I said, work with some of these big contractors, work with these big companies, work with GW, work with the city, work with the mayor, work with other council members to deliver on a lot of our issues. And so, you know, I've been behind the scenes for a number of years, and I will continue to really do that work. And I'm just grateful to be here as a candidate for city council to be able to do that. And finally, our bold ideas. And so, you know, my background is in writing policies, writing legislation, and being able to, you know, my various roles, put infrastructure in place and implement a lot of initiatives that I've, you know, been grateful to think of or explore from other cities and other regions, countries too. And so we just haven't seen that. And so some have been small, some have been big wins. And mm-hmm. so I'm bringing that to the table, to the forefront, because Ward 8 deserves someone who has the background, someone who can deliver on the council, someone who can leverage relationships, and really someone who has big ideas, because our issues are really challenge opportunity areas, rather, to get creative and work and solve our solutions.
Definitely, definitely. And, you know, this pandemic has changed a lot, but it's also highlighted a lot of other things. And one of those things being highlighted is, you know, absentee voting. So I see that the mayor is encouraging people, you know, to mail in vote and stuff like that. You know, what are your thoughts on this, and what's the advice that you're giving to our viewers?
You know, we're telling all our voters and then all our residents to please vote by mail. We want to keep them as safe as possible. We don't want to have an outbreak or a spike because of voting. Voting is sacred, but we want to ensure that they're able to exercise that fundamental right, but in the safest manner possible. And so these are unprecedented times, and so they call for unprecedented measures. And so we're telling everybody to please call the Board of Elections to request your ballot or to download the app. It's a very simple process to download your ballot and then or your request for the ballot, or to, you know, go to the website to really get that resolved. And so we don't want this to be any type of voter suppression. We want to have our residents engaged and make sure they exercise their fundamental rights. And so, you know, it's been sacred for, you know, our country, and especially African Americans, mm-hmm. And it is primarily African American. And so we're going to make sure that everybody exercises that fundamental right and is able to exercise that privilege.
Of course, definitely. And so if people want to go there and follow you or support your campaign, how can they do that?
So please, you know, we appreciate the support. It is www.mikeaustin.com, mikeaustin8.com. All social media platforms are Mike8Austin.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, thanks so much for joining me today, Mike. It was great chatting with you.
It was my pleasure. I appreciate the time.
Thank you. And to our viewers, thank you for watching.